Hunter Biden is the most protected person in the country.
This barely functional human who's got this roaring crack addiction and roaring sex addiction.
Leaving meetings every 10, 15 minutes, smoking crack, snorting coke or something, in the middle of negotiating some of these deals.
Tens of millions of dollars. It came from the Ukraine, it came from China, it came from Russian entities.
And walked in a customer clutching three MacBook Pros. When I asked for his last name, there was a long pause and he kind of sarcastically added Biden.
There is a massive amount of material here that's very damaging to Hunter Biden, Joe Biden, Jim Biden.
It shows corruption at the highest level of the American government.
Breaking tonight, the third story in a row, there are new developments in the Hunter Biden email story.
When I got on the plane, I mean, I was running. I was afraid and I was scared and I left.
I probably said too much. The NSA will be on my ass.
Hunter Biden, the son of President Joe Biden, is both an enigma and an open book. He's published a revealing memoir. His shadowy dealings have been investigated by congressional committees. He abandoned his laptop with thousands of photos, videos, emails, and text messages that fill in the rest of his life of drug use, sexual depravity, and high-level wheeling and dealing, facilitated, as Hunter Biden readily admits, by the Biden name.
I think you have to begin the Hunter Biden story with the tragic passing of his mother in an automobile accident.
Hunter Biden has said his first memory is lying in a hospital next to his brother Beau after that December 1972 accident in which his sister also died. He was 2 years old.
The both of them were in the hospital, holding each other's hands, saying, I love you, I love you, I love you.
Joe, only 30 at the time, had been elected senator weeks earlier and weighed giving up the position to stay home with his boys. He decided instead to take his seat and was sworn in from his children's bedside.
He made the choice that he would go to Washington and take up this very big career in the Senate. It was a prize that he would not give up.
Joe Biden made the three-hour round-trip commute between Delaware and D.C. His sister and mother took care of the boys during those long days.
He has said that people encouraged him and persuaded him that it was the best thing to do for his children. But if you listen to Hunter, he certainly, I think, missed the fact that he'd lost his mother and pretty much lost his father.
In his memoir, Hunter traces his woes back to the accident.
I don't see that tragic moment as necessarily resulting in behaviors that lent themselves to addiction. That would be a cop-out. But I do have a better understanding of why I feel the way I do sometimes. It was a lonely place to be as a child, and it's a lonely place to be now.
When Hunter was 7 years old, Joe married English teacher Jill Jacobs. They had a daughter, Ashley. Hunter describes an idyllic childhood, palling around with his older brother and best friend, Beau. But texts and emails on his laptop suggest a more complicated relationship. Hunter describes himself as
the loser brother, always following along behind his superstar brother, picking up the crumbs he left on the floor. All of my friends have always thought of me as a joke and the clown that Beau took care of.
And Hunter underscored a crucial trait that separated him from Beau.
The biggest difference between us, I drank and Beau didn't. The first drink I ever took, knowing what I was doing, or more accurately, knowing what I shouldn't be doing, was in the summer between 8th and 9th grades. The troubling thing, looking back, getting blasted and sick as a dog didn't scare me or turn me off one bit. Instead, I thought it was kind of cool.
Meantime, his father won re-election in 1978 and 1984 with a lot of help from his family.
Joe Biden, in all his political campaigns, always emphasizes the fact that it's a family affair, that, you know, his sister is his campaign manager, that his brother is involved in fundraising. And that sounds like a great story, but the flip side of it is individuals are getting paid. Valerie Biden, his sister, who's run his campaign, has taken in millions of dollars in fees serving as his campaign manager. And let's just be clear, Joe Biden's re-election in Delaware is never really in doubt. So the simple fact is the Biden family became enriched through this arrangement that Joe Biden set up, spending campaign dollars and giving it to members of his own family.
As today, I announce my candidacy for President of the United States of America.
The 1988 presidential election approached, and Joe, now 45 years old, was ready to reach for the brass ring.
I went to law school on a full academic scholarship, the only one in my class to have a full academic scholarship.
It did not go well.
I won the international moot court competition. I was the outstanding student in the political science department at the end of my year. I graduated with 3 degrees.
He got caught lying about his academic achievements.
And I'd be delighted to sit down and compare my IQ to yours if you'd like, Frank.
He also got busted for plagiarizing a speech from UK politician Neil Kinnock.
My ancestors who worked in the coal mines in northeast Pennsylvania and come up after 12 hours and play football for 4 hours.
Was it because they were weak? Those people who could work 8 hours underground and then come up and play football.
He had to apologize as well for stealing a speech from Robert Kennedy, word for word.
It doesn't measure the beauty of our poetry, the strength of our marriages, the intelligence of our public debate, the integrity of our public official.
Now to the tough part, my record in law school.
It was next revealed he almost got kicked out of law school.
Found that in his required paper in a course on legal methods, Mr. Biden used 5 pages of published law review articles, of a published law review article, without quotation or citation. That's precisely right.
Hunter says it was, quote, awful to watch his father become a national laughingstock.
There will be other opportunities for me to campaign for president.
After Joe dropped out, a devastated Hunter even tried to punch out hecklers at a football game who taunted his father. That kicked off a rough high school senior year for Hunter. He went from, quote, drinking in earnest to using coke to being arrested for the drug on the Jersey Shore after graduation.
He had a cocaine bust when he was still in high school at the age of 18. That record was expunged.
This scrape with the law didn't scare the senator's son straight. He continued to use cocaine through college at Georgetown University. Senior year, he met Bicycles, a homeless DC crack dealer.
It was at the height of the crack epidemic in the early 1990s, and with the fledgling addict's wrong-headed sense of misadventure, I decided to see what all the hubbub was about. Bicycles then sold me what little crack she had on her and told me to get the hell out.
As you'll see, years later, when Joe Biden was vice president, Hunter sought out the still homeless Bicycles and they moved in together. But back in 1992, after graduating from college, Hunter met Kathleen Buell at a Jesuit volunteer program. She got pregnant after 3 months of dating. They wed in 93 before Maisie, their first daughter, was born. Meanwhile, Hunter eyed law school.
Hunter Biden wanted to go to Yale.
But perhaps not as much as his father, Senate Judiciary Chairman. Joe presided over the confirmation of judges who hailed largely from the Harvards, Yales, and Columbias. Author Ben Kramer reports Biden is saying, there's a river of power that flows through this country, and it flows from the Ivy League. Yale rejected Hunter, so he went to Georgetown, but got into Yale the next year, thanks, he claims, to a most improbable credential, his brilliance as a poet.
I applied to Yale again and included with my application a poem I wrote, something everyone discouraged. Yale's acceptance letter noted that my success and dedication during my first year of law school at Georgetown more than qualified me, but that my poem was unlike anything they'd ever received and earned me my spot there.
We tried to confirm this story with Yale, but they were unable to answer. Miranda Devine thinks there's a much more obvious explanation.
Assisted by his father's contacts, obviously, as with everything else in his life, to get into Yale Law School, and he didn't have the marks for it.
After law school, Hunter went back to Wilmington and scored a $100,000 a year VP gig with a big Delaware bank. That was a lot of money back then, even for a Yale law grad.
He took a job with MBNA, which is a massive bank in Delaware. They hired Hunter as a finance executive. He didn't have background in finance.
But MBNA was one of the largest donors to his father's 1990 Senate run, in which Hunter served as deputy campaign manager.
Hunter Biden's life has really been laid out for him by his father, who assigned Hunter the role in the family of being the bagman, the moneymaker. He was given these jobs with enormous salaries well beyond his credentials.
You really can't find a case of any business venture Hunter Biden is involved in that does not revolve around his father's political power.
But you can find on Hunter's laptop evidence that through the years, Joe demanded a substantial cut of every gig his son got, and Hunter was at times resentful. For instance, this group text from 2019.
I hope you all can do what I did and pay for everything for this entire family for 30 years. It's really hard. But don't worry. Unlike Pop, I won't make you give me half your salary.
And in a predominantly incoherent email to his aunt, Hunter complained he had to pay off his brother's student loans.
Dad never paid one dime.
In 1998, Hunter moved to the Commerce Department in Washington. Then 3 years later, started a DC lobbying firm where he pocketed hundreds of thousands in consulting fees from MBNA while his father pushed legislation that would make it harder for consumers to file bankruptcy.
In retrospect, wasn't it inappropriate for someone like you in the middle of all this to have your son collecting money from this big credit card company while you were on the floor protecting its interests?
Look, the fact of the matter is that I have had an entire career that no one has ever questioned whether or not anybody has influenced me.
He became a lobbyist in a special area, which was getting sort of budget line favors for specific entities in the state of Delaware, where his father was the senior senator. So again, why is Hunter Biden in that position? I would argue because his father was the one who was going to make the decisions on who was going to get those carve-outs in pieces of legislation.
One thing that's not up for debate: Hunter, by then a father of three daughters, was also an alcoholic, though a functioning one, he insists.
I was a functional alcoholic. I always could drink five times more than anyone else, but now I was staying overnight, not making it home in time to take the kids to school in the morning.
He moved his family from Delaware to Washington in 2003, but kept drinking until he landed in rehab.
I admitted myself into the Crossroads Center, a residential rehab program in Antigua, founded 5 years earlier by Eric Clapton. I stayed there for a month. It worked.
Meantime, Joe became chair of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee, and his family's business went international.
The Biden family ambitions go from Delaware and some of these other deals to this massive global enterprise that incorporates the far corners of the planet.
In 2006, while Hunter was still heading his lobbying firm, he also joined forces with Joe's brother Jim to purchase a New York hedge fund called Paradigm Global.
Why people believe that Hunter Biden, with no background in finance, and James Biden, with little background in finance, could run a hedge fund, who knows?
Whether K Street lobbyist or Wall Street money manager, the pitch was the same. They were selling Joe. Charles Provini, who James and Hunter recruited to serve as the fund's president, said both repeatedly cited Joe's political ties. "Don't worry about investors," Jim Biden reportedly bragged to another executive. "We've got people all around the world who want to invest in Joe Biden."
And that's, I think, a further indication that so much of the family's wealth is tied up with the political fortunes of Joe Biden.
For better or worse, it seems, Hunter and Jim's hedge fund turned out to be a flop. So did Joe Biden's next run for president in 2008, which infamously began with a cringe-inducing compliment to the new kid in the race, Senator Barack Obama.
I mean, you got the first sort of mainstream African-American who was articulate and bright and clean and a nice-looking guy. I mean, that's a storybook.
Biden finished with less than 1% in the Iowa caucuses and dropped out. Obama, upon winning the nomination, tapped Joe as his running mate.
The next vice president of the United States of America, Joe Biden!
The Obama administration was on board for Joe, with one exception.
When Joe Biden is chosen to be Barack Obama's running mate, the Obama team lets it be known that they do not think it's good that Hunter Biden is a lobbyist.
The biggest issue that they had with Joe was these sort of grace and favor jobs that Joe had organized for Hunter and Hunter's lobbying and how he was influence peddling in Washington. And they wanted to, go into office or win an election as a squeaky clean team. So Hunter was asked to step away from lobbying.
Hunter quickly found a new career path. And with his father officially vice president, he was seeing money like never before.
Hunter Biden gets together with a couple of old college friends, Devin Archer and Chris Hines, who happens to be the stepson of Senator John Kerry. And they decide they want to start a new financial firm that's going to specialize in private equity.
The three of them together started a company called Rosemont Seneca. The fact that they are the sons or stepsons of people in the administration, powerful Democrats in Washington, certainly was the basis of their business. The sorts of doors were open to him that Goldman Sachs would kill for.
Hunter and Hines exchanged emails in which they fancied themselves a real-life James Bond, Jason Bourne duo sitting down with foreign oligarchs. Robert Davi is the director of My Son Hunter.
Inordinate amount of deal-making that went on with a variety of nefarious people.
Every famous, infamous international person who came to Washington, D.C. and met with his father, Hunter generally got an introduction.
Foreign oligarchs and foreign governments are currying favor and getting favors from the most powerful family in America, which is the Bidens.
In his memoir, Hunter Biden claims he stayed sober from his first rehab stint in 2003 until his father's second year as vice president in 2010. By that time, Hunter was trotting the globe and tempting fate.
You find yourself flying home from a business trip in Madrid on the red eye, overworked, sleep deprived, no exercise in 3 months. You're grateful when a flight attendant stops by your seat and asks, as she has asked everyone around you, if you'd like a drink. Without hesitation, without really even thinking, you answer, as I answered, I'll have a Bloody Mary. You're off to the races.
Hunter would be off to the races for most of his father's career. In our next episode, the Ukrainians are in, the Secret Service is out, and the son of the vice president descends into a debauched world of crack cocaine, parades of prostitutes, and stink to high heaven financial deals with odious oligarchs.